Hello all. So in the last class we have seen what are different components that are present in the packaged food. Those components are very essential or important to our body. So we get those from food. As I told you, if you consume the food, we get all those important or essential components to our body. Okay. So we have seen carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals. So these are very important for our body to get energy or to do work or to grow. Okay. So our body, and we are growing. So to grow, we need all this, and to do work, to get energy, we need all this. Okay. So these are essential components of food. So these, if we consume, if we take food which is full of these components, so we can tell that we are healthy, we are taking healthy food. Okay. So along with these you also need water and fiber to the body. Okay. So to function for the functioning of the body, you also need water and fiber along with this. Okay. So the water is also very important to our body. So we have seen two, let us do activities. Now we will see the activity which confirms the presence of all this. Okay. So we are telling, you have already seen packet, back side of the packet, that you have carbohydrates of 200 grams, proteins of 400 grams, like that. Okay. So if you have to know whether it is present or not, they will give in the food, the packet. Okay, but whatever we are cooking in our home, that in those food items, what are present, that we don't know. Okay, so we can test in our food samples in our lab or in our class, so that we can know what type of component is present in what food. Okay, so this activity is related to those experiment to confirm the presence or to tell these components are present in it. Okay, so you have different testing process for each of this that we will discuss now. So in let us do 3, there is confirmation of presence of food components. So we have seen this protein, carbohydrates, sugar. So these are all there in food, and we have to confirm it. We have to tell whether it is present or not. Okay. So to do these there are some 3-4 experiments given. So to do all those, you need these materials. Okay. So you need milk, you need a potato and oil or ghee. Okay. So to test the presence of these food components, these are required. These food materials are required. Then you also need test tubes. I will show what are test tubes, and stand to keep those, and a plate and a dropper. So these all I will show how they looks and how we will do the experiment. Okay. So now the first experiment is test for starch. Okay. Starch is nothing but carbohydrate. So in carbohydrate only, starch, sugar, these are all present. Okay. So you can tell the test for starch or test for carbohydrates. Okay. So how this test is done, now I will show the experiment how it is done. So this activity, this or the experiment, this is for testing the presence of starch. Okay. First we will see starch. So we know that we require milk, and we also require potatoes. These are test tubes, and this is a stand, and this is the iodine solution. So iodine is one chemical that is used to test the starch. Okay. So this iodine is one chemical solution. So it will be in liquid form. So that is why you call it as solution. Okay. So this for testing starch or testing carbohydrates, iodine is very important. Okay, so this iodine solution is main. It is used as dye or indicator. That means indicator means it tells whether starch is present or not. Okay, so that is why iodine solution is used as indicator in testing the presence of starch. Okay, so in our book it is given like how to prepare iodine solution, dilute iodine solution. So first iodine you will get as a crystals, or you will get as small balls. Okay, you have to take those iodine crystals and mix it with water till it becomes yellow or little brownish color. Okay, so then iodine solution, now as you have seen here, so iodine solution is little brown in color. Okay, so if you do those iodine crystals mixing in water, you will get iodine solution. Okay, so after this you have to take test tubes. Like we have whatever food samples we have to take in test tubes. Okay, here in our book it is given milk, potato and oil. Okay, so we need only three test tubes. In one test tube we will add milk, in one other test tube we will add potato, in one more test tube we will add oil. Okay, and after adding those we have to take a dropper. This is dropper, and we have to put 2 to 3 drops of iodine solution to all the food items. Okay, so you have seen, so they have put here. Okay, so here now this the iodine solution is turning blue color. Okay, so this blue color indicates the presence of starch. Okay, so initially first in at the first the iodine solution is this color, brown or yellow in color. Okay, after you put drop of one or two drops of iodine solution to food item, that will become blue in color. Okay, so that will tell you the presence of starch. Okay, so here in this three samples that we have, oil, milk and potato will turn blue in color because potato will have more amount of starch in it. Okay, so in this way we will test the presence of starch in any food item. So we have seen blue color that appeared on the potato, like in potato test tube. But if you see milk sample, it is not turning blue in color. It is same as white. Okay, so and oil also the same as what is the color of the oil, the same way oil and milk looks. Okay, so this tells that there is no starch present in milk and oil. Starch is present only in potato. Okay, so along with potato you also have starch in rice also. Okay,
okay, so that is the activity to test the presence of starch. Okay, so that is one first experiment that we have seen today. So you write down what is the procedure or how the experiment was done in your notebook. Keep experiment 1 test for starch as a heading, and write down the procedure how iodine solution is prepared and what samples we have taken to test the presence of starch, and also you have seen the video, how they have done the procedure you have to write in the notebook. Okay, so that is first experiment, that is test for starch. So we have seen milk, potato and oil. So in these three items we saw only potato contains starch, and also I told rice also contains starch. So apart from rice and potato, what other food items will contain starch, that also you need to find out and write, like what, which food items or what food materials contain more starch in it. Okay, so the next test for protein fats we will see in the next session.